Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our district auditorium here at Conemaugh Valley School District. My name is Matt Muller, incredibly proud to be the principal at New Oxford Middle School. And boy, oh boy, it's a great day to be a junior. Look at the crowd out there. You're in for a treat here tonight. You have some great kids. We have some great kids here at the school to work with. I know a lot has gone into what you're about to see. The kids look forward to these types of performances. And every time I walk by those music rooms over there, all three of them, our kids are getting after it. So it's pretty special. The arts are special. And again, sit back and enjoy the show. I would ask you to check out some of the concert reminders on the backside of the program. Silencing cell phones and that type of thing. But again, 7 o'clock, welcome to the show.
I usually don't talk before the first song, but I need to tonight because you're gonna hear some sounds that are kind of unusual coming from the students, so I thought I should read a little bit about what this song is about. The Forge of Vulcan. In Greek and Roman mythology, Vulcan was the god of fire and metalworking. The Forge of Vulcan musically describes the moods and sounds of an imaginary workplace of this ancient blacksmith. This is the Forge of Vulcan.
Thank you.
next piece, we're going to slow the pace down a little bit. Nettleton is based on an old American hymn. This is Nettleton. Next piece, we actually had the good fortune to have the composer come in and work with the students a couple of weeks ago. Dr. Travis Weller is professor of music up at Messiah University, and he was gracious enough to come down and work with the students. Some of you might have seen that on various social media posts. Mr. Muller was gracious enough to put that out there. A couple of program notes about this song, just so you get an idea of what the inspiration is behind this tune. In the late 1800s, the American Old West provided a backdrop for a host of legendary colorful characters, including gallant lawmen and infamous outlaws. Mr. Charles E. Bowles, better known as Black Bart, was one such notorious outlaw who operated in Northern California and Southern Oregon. Beginning in July of 1875 through his final robbery in November of 1883, Black Bart made daring thefts of stagecoaches, mostly operated by Wells Fargo. Though he received fame for those bold robberies, Bart was also known for holding up coaches with an unloaded shotgun, never harming a passenger, and leaving behind poetic messages after his heist. Detectives eventually tracked Bart down only 9 days after his final heist, and after his trial, determined that he committed 28 robberies during an 8-year criminal career. After serving 4 years in jail for his crimes and receiving a pardon, it was reported that Bart moved to Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. This is the last Stagecoach Heist. And before we play our final selection this evening, I'd like to take this opportunity to recognize our eighth graders on the stage tonight. This is their last time performing as members of the middle school band. I'm looking forward to hearing them and seeing them grow and expand their musical interests in the future, hearing them in the high school program in the years to come. But I do want to say a huge thank you to them for sticking it out through everything that's gone on the past couple of years. So eighth graders, if you would please stand so we can all clap for you. Please stand up. Thank you. Special children on this stage. They have worked extremely hard this year, as you can tell, the fruits of their labors here. They sound fantastic, one of the finest middle school ensembles I've stood in front of in my career. So I hate to see them go, but I'm excited for them for their future. And seventh graders, next year we'll make it even better. Our final piece this evening is a concert march. This is Capstone. Thank you.
Troubled Chorus, our all-female choir here at New Oxford Middle School. The song you just heard was Waving Through a Window from the new musical Dear Evan Hansen, and it featured our soloist Lillian Kratz, Joey Gatz, and Lila Sponseller. Our next selection that we will be singing, if you take a look in your program, is technically called a piece. It is called Two Singing Songs by Bob Chiokai. In musical terms, this is called a piece rather than a song because there are two songs in it. You can probably see that because there's some numbers underneath it. So the first song is called Sing You Now. It's a beautiful arrangement of a poem by a British Renaissance composer whose name is Thomas Ravenscroft. And fun fact, he's the man who wrote Three Blind Mice. This sounds nothing like Three Blind Mice. It sounds a lot better than that. And then the next song, it's called The Singing of Birds, and it's a beautiful arrangement of text from Song of Solomon. So in this piece, after I finish Sing You Now, you will see my arms will stay up. I'm gonna please that you not clap after Sing You Now. We're gonna perform these two songs back to back, and then when I lower my arms after the singing of birds, then you can clap. Thank you.
Oh.
while the ladies are moving spots on the risers. Our final piece is called The Storm Is Passing Over, which we are singing in three-part harmony, which is very exciting. We have soprano one, soprano two, and alto. I thought this piece was not only appropriate because number one, it's the end of the school year. Number two, today was our last day of PSSA testing, so very suiting for that. But number three, I was actually supposed to perform this piece with my treble chorus back in May of 2020. That didn't happen, so it's really nice to be able to bring this piece back when we're all back together again after 2 years of being away from one another. So please enjoy The Storm Is Passing Over.
My soul, and let us journey on. Welcome to the orchestra portion of tonight's concert. My name is Ashley Creel, and I am the middle and high school orchestra director here at New Oxford. The first piece you heard was, of course, Over the Rainbow. Our next piece is an arrangement from a Haydn string quartet called The Bird. Listen closely, and you'll hear our different sections talking to each other, almost like they're chirping back and forth like birds in springtime. I'd like to take a moment to recognize the eighth graders in this ensemble. They have worked so hard these past 2 years, during 2 years that were very not normal at that. I have truly enjoyed getting to know them, and I'm so proud of them. Eighth graders, please stand. Springfest in April. They largely learned their music on their own and came together with several other schools to perform a concert. String Fest students, please stand. Our final piece is an original piece called Stargazer, a fun tune that required lots of hard work and became a favorite for many students. Thank you for coming, and we hope you enjoy Stargazer.
Thank you.
So this is mixed chorus, our male and female choir here at New Oxford Middle School. Our first piece was an arrangement of an African-American spiritual and featured Fernando Angeles and Grant Walton as our soloists. Our next piece we will be performing is taken from a poem written by Emily Dickinson. Emily Dickinson was a textbook example of an introvert, and I'm sure if she was still alive today, she would have thrived during the COVID-19 lockdowns. She would have been in her element. Emily Dickinson loved nothing more than to stay at home, and she really enjoyed gardening. She actually had a garden in her backyard, and this is where she spent most of her time, and this is where most of her poems come from. This song that we're gonna be performing next, it is called The Bee, and it's about a bee, an entire poem about a bee. And then after we perform The Bee, our last piece is going to be the piece Seize the Day. It is from the musical Newsies, and it will feature a student accompanist, Sarah Beeman. We hope you enjoy these next two songs.
Thank you.
treble chorus ladies up front. While they're making their way up, I'd like to take this time on behalf of myself, Mr. Rohrbaugh, and Ms. Creel to thank Dr. Perry, the CBSD School Board, Mr. Muller, Mr. Beeman, and Mr. Bowman for their support of our programs. This has been such a rewarding year, having all of our students with us again, and it is exciting to see how our ensembles are thriving once more. I feel like I have personally gone through so much with this group of students as we navigated the last 2 years. Not only were we all split up last year, but I also went away on maternity leave last year, so it's been a really hard year for us, but it's been so nice to be together once more. I would like to recognize our eighth graders. Eighth graders, if you could just wave, I'd like to recognize you. We've been through a lot, so thank you for sticking with me, eighth graders. I'll really, really miss you next year. I'd also like to thank our accompanist, Ms. Mack, for pouring all of our choirs today, so please give her a round of applause. And last but not least, I definitely have to thank all of the parents out there that have supported our students. Our programs would not be possible without you, and we are so thankful for all the rehearsals that you help these students make, instrument repairs, extracurricular activities, and everything else you have navigated to make this concert happen. So students, can we please give our parents a round of applause? This final piece is You Can't Stop the Beat. It is from the musical Hairspray. Over the weekend, I took a group of students from the band, chorus, and orchestra, and we went to the Hershey Theater and saw this live, and it was a blast, right? It was a lot of fun, so I'm really excited to perform this piece. This piece will feature Cole Smith on the drums and Alex Sutliff on the bass. We hope you enjoy our concert and have a wonderful rest of your school year.
You can't stop the now, revelation, the grace, it is now and here.
and have a wonderful rest of your evening. Goodbye.